Why do Russian tank turrets fly off? You've probably seen it. Videos of Russian tanks exploding, their turrets launched high into the air. People say it's unique to Soviet designs, unlike Western tanks. So is that just propaganda or the truth? Let's find out. It can happen to any tank. In reality, any tank can lose its turret if the ammunition inside detonates. But yes, it happens more often with Soviet tanks, and there are two clear reasons why. Reason 1, numbers. The first is simple, there are more of them. The T-72 is the most widely produced main battle tank in the world. From the Middle East to Eastern Europe, from Africa to Ukraine, old Soviet tanks are still fighting in nearly every modern conflict. Naturally, they're also the tanks most often seen destroyed on camera. More tanks in combat means more viral footage and more flying turrets. Reason 2, design. The second reason is design. Many blame the Soviet autoloader, the rotating system under the turret that replaced the human loader. Western crews mockingly called it the devil's carousel. But the real problem isn't the autoloader. It's where the ammunition sits. In tanks like the T-64, T-72, T-80, and T-90, shells are stored below the crew, right under their seats. When a shaped charge jet from a HEAT round burns through the armor, it creates massive overpressure inside, enough to ignite the ammo beneath. The resulting blast goes upward, blowing the turret clean off the hull. Western tanks differ. Western main battle tanks, like the Abrams, Leopard, or Challenger, also carry explosive shells, and some even have autoloaders. But their ammo storage is separated from the crew, usually in the rear of the turret, behind armored doors and with special blow-off panels. If the ammo cooks off, those panels are designed to vent the blast outward, saving both the tank and its crew. The trade-off. Still, Soviet engineers made this trade deliberately. By placing the autoloader below, they could remove one crewman, shrink the tank, and make it harder to hit. That's why Soviet and Russian tanks have such low compact silhouettes. In fact, the lowest of any main battle tank in the world. Their smaller profile makes them less visible and harder to target on the battlefield, especially in hull-down positions. So yes, the flying turret effect is real, but it's not just a flaw. It's the price of a design built for simplicity, mass production, battlefield practicality, and stealth through a lower silhouette.